President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. meets with United Nations Chief Antonio Guterres and other world leaders at the sidelines of the UN General Assembly in New York. The UN says Marcos and Guterres discussed areas of cooperation and exchanged views on international issues and climate action initiatives. The Philippine leader also met with Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida and former British Prime Minister Tony Blair, who heads a nonprofit group that supports globalization initiatives of governments. Marcos said he and Blair discussed the peace process in the Bangsamoro region and explored concrete ways to address other priority issues, including food security and climate action. Meanwhile, the palace has confirmed the Philippine executive chief will meet with the U.S. President Joe Biden on Thursday. It did not give further details, but said it's an opportunity to discuss Philippine-U.S. cooperation on two-way trade and investments. There can be no climate justice under Marcos. Those strong words coming from climate activist Greta Thunberg in a video message during an event commemorating the 50th anniversary of the Martial Law Declaration at the University of the Philippines in Diliman. Appearing alongside other young activists, Thunberg said, "Climate justice cannot be attained under fascist leaders." Her statement comes after President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. urged developed economies to do more to fight climate change at the 77th United Nations General Assembly in New York. And here at home, the Philippine peso touches yet another record low against the dollar. But as Juan de Guzman tells us, the Asian Development Bank is keeping its optimistic outlook for the Philippine economy.
The Philippine economy is expected to outperform its peers across developing Asia, in spite of elevated inflation and record lows for the Philippine peso against the U.S. dollar. At least that is what the Asian Development Bank expects. The Asian Development Bank has the Philippine economy growing 6.5% this year, tied for the best expansion in the region with Vietnam. And for 2023, the ADB has the Philippines growing 6.3%, second best in the region. Powering this growth, domestic demand. The ADB says the reopening of the Philippine economy and domestic tourism will spur growth and offset the negative effects of lower demand in China, which is projected to grow just 3.3% this year due to lockdowns related to its zero COVID policies. The ADB says this will be the first time China will grow slower than the rest of developing Asia in more than three decades, making it a drag on growth rather than an engine. The Philippine economy is also expected to grow in spite of elevated inflation. The ADB actually raised its inflation outlook for the Philippines to 5.3% for the year from a 4.9% forecast made in July due to the impact of bad weather on local food production and higher global commodity prices. But when compared to regional inflation rates, the Philippines isn't doing that badly. The Asian Development Bank says there is another headwind, aggressive monetary policy tightening by the U.S. Federal Reserve, which is forcing the U.S. dollar to appreciate against most other currencies. The ADB says this could be a boon for dollar-earning exporters and service providers, but it could also be a bane for import-dependent nations. The Philippine peso has hit successive record lows against the U.S. dollar, closing at 58 against the greenback in Wednesday trade. However, the ADB says that isn't as bad as other currencies.
The peso has depreciated by about 13% so far. The Philippines is not at the extreme end. It's actually very much close to the average for the region. So it's really, again, driven by the Fed tightening. Whether that continues depends a lot on what will happen in the U.S. in terms of inflation. It's likely that the Fed will continue hiking, and that will continue putting pressure on currencies in our region to depreciate, including on the Philippine peso.
The Philippine Central Bank will meet for its own rate-setting meeting on Thursday. Many expect it to raise interest rates by 50 basis points to keep up with the U.S. Federal Reserve's tightening, which in turn should slow the peso's fall against the dollar. The ADB forecast for the Philippines is at the low end of the Development Budget Coordination Committee's 6.5 to 7.5% growth forecast range for 2022. Its inflation outlook, meanwhile, is at the high end of the DBCC's forecast range of 4.5 to 5.5%. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.